they'll look back and say, we've got the 11 points, if only.
Yes, and that's something which they'll have to look back and figure things out, just reassess how things went, what they could have done differently, and that's a usual practice. But credit to them that that they did come back. You know, the best they could have done was after that shake-up, the big shake-up, and more importantly, the public shake-up which they had to deal with.
Won all four.
I mean, that's the best thing they could have done. If it had to be their World Cup, then they would have certainly gone through. But they did show a lot of character in terms of getting back on the winning streak. It's not easy. You know, it's not easy when people are putting you down. The amount of pressure which was put on them, the expectations which all the fans had from them, which went the other way, and it got very emotional as well. You know, there were a lot of emotions flowing around, be it from the team, from the fans, everyone. So I think they've done enough. Enough to reassure the fans that they got to back them. They got to back them, they got to support them through and through.
Yeah, I think, that's the thing that's a miss, right? It's like, if you look at their tournament, they have so much to be proud of, right? They've played 9 games, they've won 5, they've lost 3 games. I think what effect, and that one game was abandoned. And that game could have gone either ways. Anyone would have bet on Pakistan winning that game, given Sri Lanka's form at that point in the tournament. So, you know that they've played good cricket, they've played excellent cricket, and I think this is something the fans should notice, and fans should take into account that when they lose to India, or when they lose to, you know, these whole rivalry things are literally blown out of proportion. People have to start viewing sport as a sport, and start backing their country in their sport without any malice involved, without any emotion involved in that sense, where you don't like take them to the cleaners. Not just as I understand, people who haven't played cricket, even their former cricketers have taken them to the cleaners after that loss against India. Now today you can look at, once the performance start becoming good, you can see that they're speaking the exact opposite that they spoke about when they lost to India. And these are things that people should pay attention to when actually, you know, they have a game that they have lost to India. You know, it's not like the former cricketers also, like, it's not like the former cricketers who played for India in a World Cup before won against India, and so they're saying the same. Like, so they have the right to, you know, be harsh on these players. You have to understand that these guys go out there to try and win a game. You know, they do that, but sometimes they're not as well equipped to handle pressure of a rivalry that has been built over decades. You know, so you need to be a little more supportive, I feel. And I think with a little more support, you see when the Pakistan fans have backed this Pakistan team after that win, after the India game, you've seen how the team has just taken, taken that support and, you know, helped them motivate themselves and really produce results. So it goes to show that when there's backing and when there's support and there's positive reinforcement from the multitudes, then the team automatically starts feeling good. Now today, irrespective of what happens in the Indian team, you see that there's so much positive reinforcement towards that team that performances keep reproducing itself. Now, if Pakistan and the people of Pakistan have that same kind of emotion towards their team and this positive reinforcement, I'm sure that they'll produce results and they'll be mighty proud of their attempt and their performance in this World Cup. And a lot of things to be proud of.
And I know you were very emotional about that whole Safraz incident that happened. So while we may have been a little harsh on him saying that, do they need someone like a mini Imran Khan? But you have to give him credit for actually coming through that.
Yeah, that was extremely difficult for any cricketer to be able to listen to someone coming to you when you're holding your son, when you're holding your child in your arms, and you have someone like, you know, being abusive and being disrespectful in a public place. That's disgusting. That's not acceptable under any circumstances. It annoys me. It really upsets me when people can stoop down to that kind of level. But he was very mature about it. You know, he realized that he's a leader of a team, he's a captain of a team, and it, even though it was if it was me, I would have done something in that mode. But you know, I think anyone, if you're holding your son, if you're being insulted in front of your son, it's deeply insulting. But he held himself together, which was fantastic and, you know, didn't let his emotions take over, but he actually just walked away from the whole situation, and, you know, was a perfect example of anyone who comes under attack in that kind of a situation.
And I think what happened after that was a reflection of how his team came together and of course lifted themselves to win 4 games on the trot. It just wasn't enough.